your money, going where your money going, and like you could take it with you. But somebody been there right now. Fuck that bandit shit right now. Pop records after the motherfucking kids, and fuck the keys and shit right now. All we know that's making shit. Tomorrow, baby, that's it.
The big man with our big man, so.
Hey guys, I'm Mike Wang, back with more expert tips. And this week, let's talk about situational lineups on NBA 2K22. When loading into a game on current gen, you can
nigga.
Press start to edit your starting lineup,
bit.
As well as any.
My name is the damn better Joker.
There is the wardrobe trailblazer, the style originate.
Oh, look at me. Oh, there's somewhere on these streets. And you wouldn't do another window. Man, walk into
as well as any of the preset situational life.
Younger rich for the engines big so they won't insure me. The lady out there told me it's way too much, gone for something smaller. I said, nah, it's a myth, I'm trying to make the estate, no one to cut that corner. Get love on the streets, cause they doing me when I drop your beat. They kind of rhythm, I'm putting to sleep and I stay in my zone when I'm cooking the heat. Struggle for you, but it's not into me. Used to run for the bus, now I run to the peak. Went from nothing, it's lovely to see, so I'm mama.
At guard. At 6 feet, number 8, Kemba Walker. At center, at 7 feet, number 23, Mitchell Robinson. At forward, at 6'6", number 9, R.J. Barrett. At forward, at 6'8", number 30, Coach Lennox on Thibodeau. Once again, the starting lineup for your New York Knicks.
Welcome, everyone. Here it is at long last. It's the start of the NBA regular season. I know everyone's just as excited as we are here on 2K Sports to get things on. And before we tip off here, it's time to hear from our reporter. Hey, Allie.
Here we go.
And so off the tip, it's Boston. And the starting group for the Celtics. At the 2 and the 3, Brown and Tatum. Al Horford out there with Robert Williams. And it's Schroeder in at the point guard position. And the start of a new season, Chris. What's opening day like for a player?
Special, B.A., so special. Whether it's my first year or 15th, I always got butterflies.
Schroeder finds Horford. Outside Tatum. Pass to Schroeder. Randle with a steal. It's Barrett on the wing. Launches a three. Good. And it's Walker who picks up the assist.
Efficiency. I mean, that's an area where Walker has improved. No need to force it. Keep your eyes up. Make the right basketball.
Three.
Here's Tatum. Here's Horford. He's off on that one. Good work defensively by Randle. drive by Walker. Played it in with a nice touch off the window.
How about the quick feet of Walker that really come into play on his drives to the rack?
Outside, Williams. Got a piece of it. Randall with a steal. Fournier for three. And the Knicks, another three.
Their ball movement on this run has been tremendous. It's led to a lot of good, clean, open looks.
Celtics call timeout. Who wants a t-shirt? Make some noise. Your Knicks City Dancers. All right, fans, that was your Knicks City Dancers. Make some noise.
Just over a minute and a half played here in this one. Throws it up high, and Williams punches it home.
I love how Schroeder creates for his guys. I mean, running a play that gets another guy open.
And here's New York now. They're on an 11-2 run. Everyone knew Williams would take a little time to mature. But C-Webb, now he has, and he's making an impact.
Well, he was kind of a boom or bust prospect for that reason. He has all the physical abilities in the world, good instincts for the game. It's great to see him holding himself accountable at a high level.
Given his range, you'd expect him to capitalize on that opening.
Randall, pass to Barrett. Fires from deep. Hits the trifecta. Barrett's got six.
He's consistent from out there, especially when you give him that kind of room.
Knicks lead, 14-5.
And here in the first, approaching 3 minutes play. Here's Tatum. Some solid defense from Barrett. New York has gone 4 of 5 from distance here in the first quarter. Randall with it. Guarded now by Williams. Barrett passes to Randall from the arc. And the Knicks, another three.
Wow. Their opponent is doing a tremendous job spacing the floor.
Offensively, it's been a struggle for him.
Yeah, they need to string together some shots to have any kind of chance.
And he'll take a trip to the line for two. Clearly got fouled on that shot.
Ever since the back half of last year, Tatum's been on fire. Now, the game has slowed down for him, so he could play faster. But now he's become nearly unstoppable.
Noel, he's checked in for New York. Burks comes in for Walker.
We love the heart that Jason Tatum brings to everything. He's a player who isn't afraid to be deep, and he put the team on his back. It's like the higher the stakes, the harder he plays.
Barrett passes to Randall. Shot clock at 6. Noel with a screen on Schroeder. New York needs to get one up quick. The timer ticks. 2 points. Half and goes. And you know, in the under 25 club, Graham, some observers say they take Tatum over Doncic and others.
Well, Tatum's a big guy who's only getting bigger. His defense is almost on par now with his offense, and he has a possible MVP in his future. You're leaving him all alone? Good luck. He's going to drill that every time.
Outside Fournier. For three, Barrett. And his first miss of the night. Now 2 of 3. Boston trailing.
Remaining in the first. 2 minutes.
Outside, Brown. And it's blocked. By Noel. Good.
And it's countered.
Here's Burks. Well, he hasn't put up any points yet in this one. Kicks it out to Barrett. No luck on that one. Now Boston takes it the other way. Pass to Brown. Three-pointer. The shot comes out for New York. They've gotten 7 of their 10 shots to fall. Barrett passes to Burks. Off the mark there with a 3. Boston has gone 2 of 4 from distance to begin this one. Schroeder with it. Now Burks defending. Down low. The kick to Tatum. Second chance shot. Excellent D there from Noel.
Got to give him credit for his confidence. Hasn't hit a single shot this quarter, but he still keeps firing.
Took the opportunity when he saw it. Randall's got 6 points.
They're getting torched on the perimeter.
4 of the last 5 buckets have been threes.
Tatum passes to Schroeder. With the 10-footer. And it's blocked by Noel. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Schroeder. So for the Knicks, Reddish is checked in for Barrett and quickly subbed in for Fournier. The Celtics making a switch here. For New York, they've got 8 out of 12 shots to fall. It's quickly with a drive. Ooh, a two-handed power slam!
So far, they're owning both ends of the floor. We'll see if they can keep this going.
Yeah, we gotta be careful. Still early. They've expended a lot of energy, but they've also built a nice cushion here.
8-second difference between the shot clock and game clock. Here's Reddish. Off target from 3-point range. Quickly against Smart. 4 seconds left. And he lays it up and in.
And I love Smart pressing his advantage on the interior.
The 3, Randall. Oh, he got it up in time, but it wouldn't fall for him. And so it's New York earning this break in the action, up 10. Their defensive efforts have paid off, effectively shutting down the opposing offense. And don't go far. We'll be right back. Well, a lot of excitement around the Knicks under Coach Tom Thibodeau. All-Star Julius Randle explains how he's made them better.
Genuinely cares about you as a human being, as a person. He wants to see you.
Well, we knew how demanding Tibbs. Can be, Grant, but that personal touch. Is that something new?
No question. I mean, it's a feature of coaches nowadays. He's learned at every stop and understands it can't be all business all the time.
Great to have you with us. Second quarter of basketball. This game has not exactly been neck and neck, but plenty of time left in this one. All right, guys, what do you think about the offensive approach we've seen so far for the Knicks?
The three-pointer has been a major weapon for them in the early stages. I mean, they'd be smart to keep moving and working on the perimeter.
One thing I've also noticed is how quick their hands have been tonight. Thanks to that, they've gotten a lot of points off turnovers.
On the court right now for the Celtics, Smart and Richardson pair up in the backcourt. Robert Williams out there with Al Horford, and it's Dozier in at the 3.
Knicks lead, 29.
Pass to Dozier.
14.
And we played through the first minute here in the second. Screen by Horford. Clock at 6. Here's Smart. Buries it down low. Smart has got his second bucket of the night.
And off the jump, they were effective from deep. I don't know why they haven't continued to fire from out there.
And you can't measure Smart's value by the numbers. He does all the little things. I mean, he gives you toughness, courage.
defensively, you can't afford to let him get to the rim that easily.
Well, that might be why their deficit is what it is right now.
Coaching staff has to be upset. You can't give the opposition easy baskets like this.
Oh, great flow to that possession. Two players totally in sync with each other. And what stands out about Smart is how many winning plays he makes, Chris.
Could be shot, pass, a steal, crucial rebound. I mean, you don't care when the game's on the line.
So for the Knicks, Robinson, he's checked in for Noel. Barrett comes in for Reddish. And Fournier is subbed in for Quickley. Brown, he's checked in for Boston. Schroeder comes in for Smart. The Celtics have got two of three shots to go in the second. Schroeder passes to Richardson. Robinson against Schroeder. Back to Brown. Spins. He takes it in. And the jam by Brown.
You gotta love how Brown finishes strong, driving fast and hard to the cup for the rim-rocking Shazam.
Let's check in with our reporter, Allie LaForce.
BA, the Boston Celtics last year had the team's worst win percentage in the last six seasons. The front office admitted, as constituted, they were not a championship-caliber team. Now, for this proud franchise, accustomed to competing deep into the playoffs, the question becomes, how do they get back on top?
Yeah, that's a big one. Good stuff there, Allie. Thanks. Williams finds Richardson. Pass to Brown. Robinson with the block. Now Barrett, covered by Schroeder. And he got the whistle on the way up. So he'll be headed to the line for a pair.
One thing you know when defending Barrett, he wants to get to the rim every chance he can.
You know, Grant, on his attacks to the basket, Barrett is looking for points, a foul, or both.
Oftentimes initiating the contact, too. As he gets more established in the league, he'll get more calls to go his way.
The first free throw is good for the Knicks. Julius Randle comes in for Gibson, and it's Burks in for Walker. The Celtics also with a sub. Jason Tatum, he's checked in for Williams. And Grant, your dad played pro football. You think that players who grew up around pro sports have an advantage?
Yes, B.A. Obviously, being around a professional athlete, understanding the dedication, the sacrifice, the work that goes into it, really, I think, helped me at an early age as I was developing in a different sport. He drops yet another dime, just facilitating this offense like a maestro.
Schroeder passes to Brown. Outside Tatum, takes the three. Fires in the triple. Tatum's got five.
And their shots are dropping with more consistency now.
Pass to Burks. Randle, a screen on Schroeder. Burks passes to Randle. He got a piece of it. And he gets it back.
Oh, you can't be careless around Horford. Throw up a weak shot around him, he'll send it back.
Here's Tatum, and a miss there with a chance to cut the lead to single digits. New York has gone 2 of 3 from the three-point line in the second. Robinson finds Barrett. Outside Burks. And there's a minute 45 left in the second period. Randall, and it's Randall with the jam.
What I love about Randall is the power he plays with. He's an absolute force inside.
25. The Celtics have gotten 5 of 7 shots to fall in the second. Now here's Schroeder. There's the double with Burks. Here's Horford. That one falls. Coming off Schroeder's feed. Horford's got his second basket of the game.
They didn't do themselves any favors with their shooting in the first quarter, but they're starting to pick it up. Now
Burks against Horford. Oh, and that one, no question, powered it down.
And after putting it down, he dangles from the rim a little.
Man, that's borderline taunting right there, Grant. They're playing with a certain swagger right now.
The loudest and craziest fans get a free t-shirt. Let's see it, fans. Coming onto the court, the Monica Cow, for your next City Dancer.
Bucks making a change here. Reddish has checked in. A big group substitution here for Boston. <laughs> 58 seconds left to play in the first half. Back to Smart. Hey, expanding his range. It's rebounded by New York. Robinson's got four rebounds in the game. Pass to Randall. Burks against Tatum. Over Burks. Second shot opportunity, and he takes it up and lays it in.
Now, that's the staple of Cantor's game. This guy has a knack for knowing how to come up with offensive boards.
Burks passes to Fournier. For three, Randall. And again, New York with the triple.
He keeps working on the three-point line. I mean, that's his third triple of the game, first in the quarter.
Kicks it out to Smart. Williams, a screen on Burks. It's Smart on the wing. And Alec Burks gets the whistle that time. That's his first foul. His shot was hindered by that momentous mobile one block.
Yeah, I love that they maintain the defensive energy even when they're behind.
There's 6 seconds left in the first half of this one. Up in time. And no good. Trying to get that one to fall.
He's solid on defense. It's just solid. Randall showing more versatility.
The Celtics, 29.
Thanks so much. I'm here with Coach Tom Thibodeau. And Tom, what's it going to take down the stretch to win this ball game?
I think just tough defense, take good shots, not turn the ball over, play smart.
Back to the basics. Thanks, Coach.
Thanks very much, Allie. And folks, we'll be right back to start the second half of this game.
Greetings, everybody. We love exciting. And this game is delivered as we've seen two top players battling mano a mano.
Great fight we're seeing from both these guys. Each one trying to pull his team across the finish line. You know they love this kind of a challenge.
All right, fellas, let's check in on our first half of action and the dominating performance for the New York Knicks.
They had a tremendous first half from the three-point line. Their shot selection was pretty sound, considering how many threes they took. And the confidence of the shooters, now that's outstanding.
And that's our halftime show, thanks to the Big Diesel.
Well, thank you, Gomer Powell.
Well, does that make me the sergeant? I got to get the order around here, Ernie.
Shaq, where were you going with Gomer Pyle?
I don't know, Ernie. Is that a good act?
And with the second half upon us, we'll find out if this game becomes the rout that it's threatening to be. Julius Randle has been sensational.
Well, if he's hit threes like he did in the first half, he's going to have a monster night.
Yeah, the defense didn't do a very good job of staying connected to him, but we'll see if they make an adjustment.
Knicks shooting really well in this matchup, 62% from the floor. Inside, we have Randall and Robinson. Fournier the two, Barrett at the small forward, and it's Walker in at the point. That's the five for New York right now.
Great recognition from Randall. Seeing an opportunity to rise and fire and make use of it.
And a lot's changed for Kemba Walker. Thought out over the summer, and of course, this was after he was sent out to Oklahoma City with the Thunder. Now, Kemba gave up some cash in that buyout, but he feels like he's in a great fit with the Knicks to help them make another run.
Barrett finds Randall. Driving in, Horford with the block, and he gets it back for three. Barrett, and again, New York with the triple.
They've had a hard time shutting down the three-point shot.
Knicks lead, 48.
Schroeder against Walker, and there's the foul. It'll go on Kemba Walker. That's his first foul.
And just wasn't able to set up in time.
And that was another look at the aggressive D that led to the mobile one block.
Let's see if that block can amp up this team. I mean, they're looking for anything to get themselves going.
Some room here for Schroeder. Yes, great play by Horford to set him up. Schroeder's got six.
I mean, he does things that other bigs simply can't. Horford, a phenomenal passer for his position.
The kick out to Fournier. Another one falls for New York.
And just shredding apart the defense with his passing. He's helping to pace this offense so well.
Oh, man, so unselfish. He's doing a great job creating for others and making pinpoint passes.
And the jam by Brown.
Great physical and athletic tools. Brown's adept at pushing past contact.
Walker passes to Randall. Shoots over Horford. And too long on the shot. Boston's gotten three of their seven threes to find the net in this matchup. And it's Brown off the drive.
Oh, you gotta love the explosiveness. Brown just eating up any lane to the basket he sees.
It's Walker on the wing, covered by Schroeder. Randall can't hit.
He hasn't had anywhere near the same touch he had in the first half. 0 3-pointers in this half compared to three in the first half. He may not be thought of as big for a center, but with his ability to go vertical, he sure plays big.
A drive by Walker. And out of bounds, Boston will have it.
Boston ball.
And here's the upcoming schedule for the New York Knicks. On Friday, they'll begin a road trip starting in Orlando, going up against the Magic. The Celtics have gone an impressive 5 of 5 so far in the third quarter. Tatum finds Schroeder. A touch over 2.5 minutes of basketball played here in the third quarter. Back to Tatum. Looking to get back on track. That one falls. Coming off Schroeder's feed. Schroeder's got his 7th assist. Missed here tonight.
Soft defense. I mean, they've given up 10 of the last 12 points inside.
For the Knicks, Gibson's checked in for Robinson. Right, Noel comes in for Randall. And quickly subbed in for Walker. The Celtics also with a sub. Richardson's checked in. For New York, they've gotten 3 of 6 shots to fall so far in the third. And it's Barrett off the drive. Quickly from outside. He buries it from three. Quickly's got 7.
He'll do some damage if they give him that shot. Don't give him a clean look. Get out there on him.
And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Schroeder. And it's time to give you a look at the top three-point shooting teams from a year ago. In the third spot, the Knicks.
They ran such a great system last year. I mean, they put priority on creating high-quality shooting, and it made them the best three-point shooting team in the league.
For New York, they've gotten 4 of 7 shots to drop in the third. Quickly passes to Barrett. Smart against Quickly. Tipped away. It's stolen by Smart. It's an even 3-on-3 break. And Brown with the stuff.
Oh, nice look there from Smart. Finding the open man.
New York has gone 2 of 3 from outside so far in the third quarter. Gives us a chance to catch up with Ali LaForce.
Thanks, Brian. Historically, a few franchises have gobbled up most of the NBA championships. A significant number of teams have never won a title, though. However, we're in an interesting time. A lot of those franchises are looking for their first title. They're among the top teams now. And guys, they're hoping to get on the board.
Oh, yes. Very interesting, Ali. Thanks for that. Here's Richardson. Noel with the rebound.
2 minutes remaining in the third.
And they've been moving the ball really well tonight.
Good things come to those who take good shots.
Kicks it to Quickly. No Noel with a screen on Smart. Quickly with the ball. Guarded now by Williams. And Noel hammers it down.
Slams it down with two hands.
Man, they're really getting aggressive. Now, the drive by Smart. Opening close, and he drops it in. Smart has got his third bucket of the night.
Man, that's now 10 straight points in the paint. I'm not sure what's happened to their defense.
And a foul called on the way up. So he'll take two from the free throw line. They'll pin that one on Marcus Smart. And a closer look here at the scoring breakdown for the Knicks.
Want to see how efficient the offense is running? A great stat to look at is points off assist. And they've gotten a ton of assists throughout this game.
Also, what touch they've displayed from long range as a team tonight and throughout this entire game.
Reddish is checked in for New York. Burks comes in for Fournier. And the Celtics also making a change. Dozier's checked in for Brown. And quickly drops them both.
Now, his free throw shooting is something they never need to worry about. He doesn't even know how to go through a cold streak.
Is that my cutie with 40-foot cutie, huh? Is that my baby? Good morning, are you sleeping in your bed?
No one else, no one else.
Oh, Bubba Kickster, 1996.
One 14 left in the third quarter here. Outside Richardson, down to five on the shot clock. And the rebound goes to the Knicks. 17 points was their biggest margin. They'll take on the Magic at Amway Center after this one. It's a quick turnaround on the road, just one game. He pulls it! Quickly with a rebound. The Knicks have gotten 5 of 8 shots to go in the third. 41 seconds left in the third quarter. Reddish misses. The Celtics have gotten 8 of 11 shots to go in. Efficient so far in the third. Smart against Quickly. They grab their own miss.
That's a shot they're always happy to get, even when he blows the finish.
Works for three. Can't get it to drop. Here's Dozier. Well, he... hasn't scored yet, but I'm sure that'll change. Knocks it loose. The three is up. And so it's the New York Knicks, now holding a 12-point lead at quarter's end. They just can't miss right now. Every shot they're taking, you assume, is going in. And more NBA action on 2K Sports coming your way right after this. Assist of the game.
You know, I'm kind of stoked that this was a choice because I love this pass. A remarkable find. He put his court vision on full display.
Well, it's also called making a good read, understanding where everyone is and taking full advantage. Fantastic.
It's the fourth quarter.
Yeah. Well, there may not be a lot of drama down the stretch as we head into the fourth quarter. But stranger. Things have happened. Taking a look at the Celtics. At the two and the three, Brown and Tatum. Al Horford out there with Robert Williams. And it's Schroeder in at the point guard position. And here's Brown for three. Down the pipe it goes. Schroeder with the assist. Schroeder's got assist number 8 here already in the game. Walker against Schroeder. Drive by Walker. It's tipped. Right side, Tatum. And again, Boston with the triple.
Backing up that last three with another three. The defense has to stop giving them so many clean looks.
Schroeder against Walker. Pass to Reddish. And he can't answer back. The three-pointer offline. Boston has gone 5 of 10 from beyond the three-point line in this game. Horford finds Williams. Back to Horford. Brown. There's Tatum with the three. Walker pulls down the board.
Not his best night and not the team's best night. Sometimes it just goes that way.
Williams against Randle. Outside Burks. From deep three-point range. The Knicks miss again.
He's done a lot of the little things to help put them in front. I mean, but his offense has not been there for them.
New York has gone 0 for 2 from outside here in the fourth quarter. Tatum with a steal. Here's the break. Out to Schroeder. This one for three. Out of bounds. Celtics ball as Boston keeps possession. Fournier's checked in for New York.
Into the lineup for your New York Knicks, Evan Fournier.
Now off the inbound. Deflected. Here's Brown. Ooh, making his presence felt here. He's now 6 for 9 in this game.
Disappear since halftime.
Let's get a report from Allen.
Thanks, guys. I was able to hear Tom Thibodeau coaching his team during that last break. He loves what he's seeing from the perimeter offense. He told the team, quote, keep shooting. It's working for us. Let's bring this home. Back to you.
All right, appreciate it, Allie. And they call the 8-second violation. Too much time getting it up court.
As the game is going on, they've had trouble protecting the rock.
Schroeder against Walker. Schroeder passes to Tatum. That one falls, coming off Schroeder's feed. Schroeder's got assist number 10 tonight with that last one. Walker against Schroeder. Outside Robinson. And Mitchell Robinson picks up the foul.
Oh, come on.
That's his first foul of the game.
That's his first commitment.
Just one turnover in the first half, and now seems like they just keep on coming. He got to get a handle on that ball.
Schroeder against Walker. To tie it up. Robinson with the block. On the wing, Fournier. Trying to get back on track. Rebounded by the Celtics. Tatum's got 5 rebounds tonight. Pass to Horford. Over Fournier. And there's Horford on the assist from Tatum. And that makes it a tie ball game.
Just an intelligent play by Tatum. Moving the ball to a guy with a great shot.
Walker passes to Burks. Walker against Schroeder. They double team Walker. And Robert Williams picks up the foul. That'll be a second foul of the game.
That was a good call. The defense wasn't established.
Timeout, New York. Your next city dancer.
Barrett's checked in for Burks.
For your New York Knicks, RJ Barrett.
Hey, what up, baby?
What's up?
What's
up? In your room?
Oh, I don't know. I'm just. What time are you? 7:30?
Yeah.
Okay.
So the Knicks DK are open to trading Julius Randle.
Yeah, I don't know.
That's what happens when you get paid. When you get paid and you're not doing what you're supposed to.
It's Walker on the wing. Randle outside. 6 on the shot clock. And he'll draw the foul. He'll head to the line for 2. That one on Schroeder.
First person. Combo of strength and suddenness. Hard not to foul
Randle.
All right, guys, what do you think so far about the offensive approach for the Celtics?
Look, from mid-range, they've been deadly all day. It's really opened things up for them at the other end of the floor.
The other thing, they continue to fill it up from three-point range, making it look easy.
Reminding us again why he's one of the game's great clutch shooters.
Outside Walker. Outside Barrett. Launches it. It doesn't go for him. And Boston going the other way now. Horford passes to Tatum. Outside Brown.
Themselves in a position to win this game.
There's no panic in them. I mean, staring at a big deficit, they still kept their poise and went to work.
And it's Walker off the drive. Oh, it's blocked by Williams. Now the Celtics on the move. Horford for 3. Randle pulls down the board. Randle's got rebound number 5 here tonight. And he drives in. Barrett. And he jams it home with authority.
Putting on a show for the fans. Going up with a great surprise.
Oh, that had a little extra sauce on it, Grant. Count that.
Come on, stop going to the side, bro.
18 points now here in the second half.
He can go inside, he can shoot it, he can dominate on the fast break. And tonight, Brown is doing it all.
Here's Walker. So it'll be 2 free throws. He was fouled in the act of shooting. Robert Williams picks up 1.
I like that. I mean, some physical play inside. He's not about to give up any easy baskets.
He gets the first, and that narrows the lead down to just 3.
Not a guy you want to foul. Walker's a tremendous free throw shooter. Does a great job of getting himself to the line.
He's such a great free throw shooter who can handle big moments.
Up top, Brown. There's 53 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Pass to Schroeder. Horford, screen on Walker. Late clock, the Celtics got to hurry here. No good with the triple. It's all come down to this one critical possession.
And B.A., you can feel the intensity in this arena.
Randall against Horford. This drive by Randall.
Yes! Great to see guys who don't back down under pressure.
Yeah, he approached that with total confidence. He has what it takes to come through in the clutch.
Make some noise. Your Knicks City Dancers.
Seconds left in the final quarter. Brown against Fournier. 12 seconds left to play in the fourth. Outside Schroeder. Just four to shoot. And he lobs it up. And the lob disrupted. Not to be. Here's Fournier. Oh, the shot is good. Oh, but it looks
let's
like
go. That gotta be good. That gotta be good.
Beater. Boy, this game hangs in the balance of this review now.
Yeah, the replay makes it obvious. I mean, he got that shot off in time. It should be an easy decision for the officials.
After the review, the ruling on the floor is overturned.
The crew has made their decision. The basket is good. He got it off in time.
And even though he had it right from the start, great idea to double check it, especially when it comes to a game winner.
And so the big win by New York in a tight game. What a performance they had here at home today.
I'll tell you what, these are the ones that are so nice to win and so tough to lose. I love being on the edge of my seat, never knowing what would happen next.
And that'll do it for this inaugural game of the NBA season. For Chris Weber, Ali LaForce, and Grant Hill, I'm Brian Anderson. Thank you for tuning in to watch the NBA on 2K Sports. Now our New Balance player of the game, Julius Randle.